Hello, today I have the opportunity to be at Inspira Vineland, and I am so excited to have an opportunity to really spend some time with our pharmacists and our pharmacy team, learning about the great things we're doing. I know this is really important, especially this time of year, because flu and cough and all those things happen. So let me go to our expert. Tom, how you doing? It's great to see you again.
Hi, Amy, good to see you too.
We spent a lot of time together during the COVID tents.
Absolutely.
Tell me about what we're doing here today.
So kind of want to introduce you to the pharmacy and the services that we offer. Okay. And just to kind of keep it in mind, we do have like a full suite of over-the-counter product. We have obviously prescriptions we fill, and we also do services such as vaccine therapies and stuff, vaccinations and whatnot. We have two convenient locations, one here in Vineland, one in Mullica Hill.
Located right in the hospital.
And located right in the hospital.
Trying to make it easy for everybody,
right? Very convenient. Just keep in mind, not every cough and cold requires an antibiotic.
That's
and I have
true.
Craig here to talk to you about it.
Hey, Craig, how are you?
Hey, welcome. Come on back.
That'll be great. I don't think I've ever been in the back of a pharmacy before. Thanks so much for giving me the time today.
So glad you could come and join us.
Tell me, how do we help people understand that there are some times that we really don't need it, and because it could make it actually not as effective when we really need it?
So antibiotics are life-saving medications. They treat bacterial infections.
Okay.
They don't treat viral infections. As we're thinking about cough and cold season, many of the infections that we see are caused by viruses and not bacteria. So you might think an antibiotic might be the best thing for me, but it's not actually going to help you get better faster. So there are some antiviral medications that help for some viruses, but most of the time we have to let it run its course. There are cough and cold remedies.
We hate that, right?
It's not fun, right?
We want something to fix us.
We want to be feeling better immediately, right? But sometimes it's going to take 3-4 days before you start feeling better, and the cough might even linger for a week or longer. But sometimes we just have to endure, get fluids, get rest. Because if you're taking an antibiotic inappropriately when you don't need one, there's a lot of problems that can result from that.
Tell me about that, because I think that most people think, I'll worry about that another time.
If you are taking antibiotics and abusing them, using them when we don't need them, bacteria are smart, and they're able to develop resistance.
I see.
So some of our common antibiotics that we would use for some of these infections may no longer work.
Then you just have to up the ante with a higher drug, and eventually it doesn't...
Eventually we run out.
You run out.
Right? And a lot of these second line antibiotics, they might not work as good as the first line antibiotic. They may have more side effects than the first line antibiotics. And we're actually running into the problem where there's certain bacteria that there aren't antibiotics that we can use.
Wow.
Which is a major problem globally.
How do you get through? What are the things that we might be able to do to help people better understand this?
We have antihistamines, we have decongestants, we have cough medicines, humidifiers. These are some of the remedies that we can use to try to help minimize the symptoms and help you get better faster for a viral infection. Now, there are certain infections that do require antibiotics.
Right.
If you have strep throat, for example, right, or certain ear infections, antibiotics are indicated a lot of those times, and we should be using them. But the important thing to take home is we don't always need an antibiotic just because you're feeling sick. And down the line, we know that people who take antibiotics frequently are more likely to have more infections.
I see.
With tougher to treat
wow.
Bacteria. So it's going to be better for you in the long run to avoid antibiotics if they're not appropriate.
So while I have your expertise here, could you just spend a couple minutes talking about our two programs that we've implemented, the Meds to Beds and the Dispensary of Hope?
So the Meds to Beds program is a great thing that we've implemented here at Inspira. So we can actually deliver it to your patient room before you leave the building, so you can just go home and get back to your normal way of life.
And that's for everybody. It's not like you have to have a special card or anything else. We can do that for everybody.
Every single patient we can do that for. And the Dispensary of Hope actually is another major benefit that we've recently implemented, where patients with financial difficulties are able to participate in this Dispensary of Hope, where we can actually provide some medications that can be very important on discharge and for maintaining their health at basically free.
What a tremendous help that is to our patients. And we know that people who take their drugs as soon as they get home are less likely to end up back in the emergency department.
So I really am grateful both for Craig's expertise and the chance to be with you today, and most importantly, to have a chance to share this information with you. Understanding the why is critical. Until we meet again, be well and stay safe.